Peter will tell us about the project Arctic Bridge. And Nadia Sarava is an expert on Arctic Bridge. She went through the project herself as a PhD student till she defended it in 2013. And she has also been a project coordinator for Arctic Bridge. For us,
good afternoon, everybody. Before I start my very short presentation about the Arctic Bridge project, I am kindly asking you to look at your conference folders, and what you can see there is a bridge. Very nice bridge. I don't know if it's good or not, but I'm asking you to keep it in mind, and we will come back to that in a few minutes. Now about the Arctic Bridge project. This project was inspired by the sudden need in a considerable number of international researchers when the delimitation line agreement between Norway and Russia was signed in 2011. And that called for combined research efforts from both sides for the researchers capable to address the complex nature of social and business problems development in environments. At the same time, the systems of doctoral training in Northern Russia did have and do have still some differences, and that challenges the cooperation on the research level. That is why the project idea to develop a Norwegian-Russian model for cooperation on the PhD level was initiated and supported by the Norwegian Center for International Cooperation in Education. The full title of the project is Arctic Bridge Cooperation on PhD Education and Research Training in the Field of Management in Extractive Industries and the High North. And this is one of the biggest, our biggest project, because it involves all our Russian partners in order to maximize the synergy and effect of our cooperation. In spite of our long and successful cooperation at master level, PhD education is different in its nature, in contrast to master and bachelor education, which are focused on collective efforts and individual knowledge production, namely master thesis. PhD education is based on individual curiosity and ambitions and collective knowledge production, or in simple words, knowledge sharing. And that is why the PhD education should not be limited to a set of personal experiences, but should be an open field or open arena for researchers to share their ideas and results. Arctic Bridge is an ambitious project, and it has received many important quantitative and qualitative results. And if to look at the project activities and results through the prism of knowledge sharing with regards to the nature and form of knowledge, namely explicit or formal knowledge and tacit knowledge or know-how, and two types of knowledge in higher education, organizational, how the knowledge production is organized, and academic or scientific, we may see that we have been quite successful in all dimensions. So in terms of explicit knowledge sharing, definitely project partners learned a lot from sharing and finding out about PhD policies and procedures in each other's universities in terms of enrollment, training and defense. They also got value from sharing databases, literature databases, for example, and learned a lot how to write applications and how to make reports on the project. teaching materials, textbooks, and learn about assessment strategies, which are also quite different. However, it is basic knowledge or know-how, which is often non-verbalized, intuitive, context-specific, personally bounded, and it is, of course, more costly and time-consuming, and therefore it is harder to share between and even within organizations. And that is why the project efforts were primarily put in this area through regular meetings between project participants. For example, annual PhD education board and reference group meetings were the source or arena for further planning of activities, sharing ideas and results. Also, joint PhD committees, when the faculties from Russia were invited to be members of the PhD committees in Norway, when Russian and Norwegian students defend their PhD thesis. In terms of this academic knowledge, we are extremely proud to have almost had seven defenses so far in Norway, seven joint PhD courses, four PhD colloquiums where students would share their current research and get feedback from both Norwegian, Russian and even international research communities. Also, we had around 20 master students semester stays in Ukhta, and also 6 PhD students internship in Ukhta, where they would work on parts of their dissertations. In terms of more sound assimilation of knowledge, we are proud to have almost published, two series of working papers, which are built on the students' course papers in the governance, and also many other joint and individual publications. So, at the end of my short presentation on harmonization of doctoral training in Norway and Russia, I would like to look at this bridge and tell me what is nice about it. Of course, everything is nice around it. Landscape, sun, the sea. This is one of the main Norwegian attractions, Atlantic Road. But I think that what is most important about this bridge, as compared to the first one, is that it is fixed, stable, and it is two-way. And I think that if we have this stable two-way communication, we will never be stuck, and we will always stay connected. And I think this is the way we should proceed our